So good morning. I'm Ashwin from Tech Joomla. Basically, Tech Joomla is a part of TechD, a company that works into Joomla, Magento, AIR applications, and Appcelerator. Tech Joomla is into Joomla extension development. We have about 2 years into business now, and then we have about 15-20 extensions and about 12,000 users on the site. These are a few of our better known extensions. Social ads allows you to create advertisement like Facebook, which is demographically targeted. So you can have advertisements targeted towards females and kids and things like that. Jbolo is a chat application for Joomla that allows you to have chatting features like Facebook or Gmail. And then Mail Alerts, which my colleague Parth talked about, is a daily digest component like Google Groups. So let's get started with the REST API. REST, as we all know, it's a representative state transfer, which means it's just a way of reading objects. The entire web or the entire all the pages that you see, they are basically REST. It's just that the pages that you see, they are human readable, whereas when we say a REST API, it's machine readable. That's what I said. So a resource on the internet, that is a link, it can be made available in a variety of formats. It can be HTML or XML or JSON or whatever. So that's what I mean by it is a representation of the same data. So as an example, a web page, if you go to joomla.org and then a list of news items, then that list is readable by you, so that's a human representation of the list. Whereas if you click on RSS, RSS is, it's in a way REST, because it renders the list of articles in a different format. So that's the difference. So some basic thoughts on REST is that each method has its own URL. So there is user/create, user/delete, things like that. It's a HTTP based communication channel, so all the data exchange happens through HTTP. Output can be a variety of formats, so you can have JSON, XML. If you have other needs, you can just have plain text output or anything that your needs are. And primarily, get post is very common. We use that in Joomla, and then put and delete. So these are some extra methods that these are used in the API. Put is typically for updating, delete is for deleting and removing, get is for reading or retrieving, and post is for saving a record. So who uses REST APIs? I think since all of you are developers, you must have used a lot of REST APIs. Facebook has it, Twitter has it, Google has it. All of these guys have REST APIs. So, I mean, on a daily basis, we build applications that use REST APIs, and I mean, we are now enabling Joomla to have a REST API of its own. So, I think most of you must be aware that Joomla already has a XML RPC server. Any of you have used it? There's always XML RPC folder in your Joomla. You must have wondered what it's for. So that's the XML RPC web service. So the REST server architecture is it's a very similar format. You have a REST folder, and then in the REST folder there's a framework that gets loaded. The framework uses plugins to do its job. So we introduce a new plugin type in Joomla called REST API, and all the plugins that you install are of the type REST API, and any plugin you install, you get a new method in your REST API. By default, the access for this REST API, it's restricted to only super admins. So anybody who's a super admin can use REST API, this API, to post data, create users, create articles, create use any methods basically. There is no authentication for get methods, but we have an authentication for post. There's no authentication for get requests at the moment. But for post request, you have to authenticate using Joomla Super Admin. The output formats that we support currently are JSON and XML. So those are the most commonly used formats today, so we support those for the time being. So quick thing on how it works is, let's say you put this API on Joomla.org, and then you call this Joomla.org /user_create.json. So .json means that the response is expected in the JSON format. And this maps to the user_create plugin that you installed using your regular Joomla installer. So that's the way the URLs and the plugins map. Right now we're supporting one method per plugin. So if you want to delete users, you create a plugin, update users is a plugin, but that's going to change. So this is a list of plugins that we have for now. We have create, update, delete for users, so which is very obvious. We also support Jom Social, and then we also support a few more Jom Social features like the wall, and very popular Joomla content, creating articles, retrieving sections, categories. That's supported for now. And a very interesting plugin that we have right now is the search plugin. So when we do the regular Joomla search, we search for a keyword and then we see results. The same thing you can achieve through a REST search plugin. So you can have an external site or any other Joomla site, use your Joomla resources, search through it, and then display the results. So the search plugin is one of the most interesting ones. Pardon? You could, yeah, we could write the plugin to work that way. So cross-site search. Yeah, I think that should be possible because it's the REST API, so you can just fetch results from other site and then show it all together. It's like FeedBurner, which compiles your RSS feeds into one feed. So it'll be like that. So we have a few more plugins in development. I was speaking to a few developers for the past 2 days. Some prefer K2, some prefer Flexi Content, some have a preference for Zoo. So most of the CCKs we're planning to write plugins for. Most of these are already done, just being tested. Then we have Jom Social photos and videos. Jom Social seems to be the most popular social component these days, so many of our clients are asking for Jom Social integration with a lot of external things like Moodle and DocuOS and some other systems. So we are heavily writing Jom Social APIs. And then Virtumart, so we have new extensions like Tienda and a lot of those guys, but still Virtumart seems to be the stronghold of a lot of shops, just because it was the only one a few years back. So a lot of shops still run Virtumart, and we have clients saying that we want the APIs to create products, to create orders, to list orders and like that. So we are developing the APIs for Virtumart as well. So as I said, right now we have implemented post and get. We really don't have, we have edit, we have all of that, but it's not really implemented via put and delete. So we are kind of working on making it a true REST feature architecture. So we have browser status codes, we have all of the methods supported. So that's one thing that we're working on. And what I mentioned is, right now for each method you have to have one plugin installed. So that's going to change. We're making it such that you can write more methods into one plugin. And then one more interesting feature that we're working on is, it is mainly for extension developers. So extension developers can directly expose their methods via APIs by adding a extra controller, a REST controller. So they just need to create method names and then map them to their own functions. So maybe K2 can have a REST controller, and then it can allow us to save articles, edit articles, and create categories, all of that. So that's something new that we're working on, because when you create plugins, it's a bit hard to create plugins, but when you're making an extension, it's fairly easy to just add one more controller and then map your stuff. I'm not sure I understand your question. Maybe when I show the demo later, that will be, so the format for any extension developer can be his components slash controllers and then the rest.php. So the rest.php is what the API server uses to map your methods. So that's something, that I just thought in the last few days while talking to these extension developers. So this is something that is just recent. Okay, so the way the API came about is because of a client who really wanted the API. And there's a very interesting story which I've turned in as a case study for this. The client is basically a big industrial workshop. They have these machines, drilling machine and all sorts of things like that. And they wanted to oversee all those machines using some kind of central console. And if there's something failing or if there's something going wrong with any machines, they needed feedback about if it's breaking down or if there's less oil in a pump or stuff like that. So that is where this API came in. So the way it works is they have a lot of machines at various locations in their factory, and all these machines are monitored by sensors like temperature, vibrations, and all of that. And all of that data is being passed on to a hub, as they call it. The hub accepts all that data, converts it into REST requests, and sends them to a Joomla installation. So whenever the temperature or vibrations or any of those stats go higher than a preset value, it creates a jump social discussion. So that's what jump social is what we are using for managing all of the machines and the people. So it sends out a discussion, rather it creates a discussion in jump social, and then it sends alert to the caretakers of the machine, maybe the engineer or maybe the maintenance guy, to the management and whatnot. So it sends out all those alerts to users. And then people discuss the causes of the breakdown or whatever on the forum, and then it's stashed away for later reference. So that's a very nice and simple thing that we build for them. So the Joomla connection for this, as I said, so we're using the profile types that Jump Social has for this. So whenever we want to add a new machine to this system, we just create a new user for that machine and assign it a profile type of machine. So each machine has its own user on the site. It's just a one-to-one mapping. And then there is physical people who want to kind of assess the machine. So we have profile types for management, caretakers, maintenance guys, and all of those. So each of those guys also has a profile on the site. Now what happens is one machine is being taken care of by a group of people. So we create job social groups for that machine. So a drilling machine is seen by four people, so we have a drilling machine group, and there's a milling machine group, and then there's a CNC group and things like that. So each group is a jump social group, and the members are the machine itself and the caretakers. What happens is, as I said, whenever there is a fluctuation in the temperature, it triggers a jump social discussion on the group. So we have a discussion creation API as well, so that is called, and a discussion is triggered. Additionally, we have facilities like SMS alerts to the caretakers and then emails to them, so that they can come to the site and see the statistical data that is being posted and then see what's going wrong. And then they do the discussion and then find out, oh, is it normal or is it not, whatever. Does the machine need some maintenance? They do the take the action, and then that's closed. So that's the kind of system we have implemented for them at the moment. So this is a quick diagram of what happens. So what I call the hub. It's called the API agent, which receives all the machine data and then passes it to Joomla. So whenever a new machine has to be added through the API agent, we call a new user creation API, and then in Joomla, a new user gets created. Then the middle slot shows the machine parameters being passed on to Joomla. So if there's any deviation, automatically a discussion gets created. And lastly, some announcements, like if there's going to be a machine shut down for some reason, for maintenance or all of that, again, that is sent over to the API agent to create announcements in the job social group so that the caretakers know that the machine is going to be off for 2 days, half an hour or whatever. So based on this, I mean, once we did the API for that client, we started getting on requests to do some more implementations. So very similar implementation is on a healthcare domain. So we have patient monitoring system. So in this case, people have blood pressure sensors and all of that on their. So it's mainly for patients who have to stay home. They can't go out, and they are alone, mainly elderly guys who have not a lot of help. So they are being constantly monitored. The vitals are monitored, their temperature, their heartbeat, and all of that. And that is being fed to again one API agent. And if there is a deviation, the caretakers of the person, which might be the doctor or his neighbors, or they are notified immediately by whatever, and then the same process happens. They discuss and close it. A very interesting system that we recently worked on is a Virtumart-based affiliate system. So what this uses, it uses the search API to return search results for a keyword. So we did this for a client who had about 90,000 products in his Virtumart shop. He used to sell small things like screws and pipes and all of that. So not big things, but small things. And he wanted to do things like drop shipping or affiliate shipping. So we gave him the search API. The search API is being used by his affiliates to search for things. And then ultimately, they create their own shops or demos. And the affiliates redirect back to the main Virtumart shop. So they get a commission based on the URL they refer. And that's the way the affiliate system works. POS is one more thing that we have worked on. So we see in supermarkets, in all of the shops, those small terminals which are called point of sale systems. So there is something similar that we're building. There's a central Virtumart store, and he wants to sell from various places. So using the API, we are kind of creating some new products, new orders. So the POS accepts the order and then sends over the order details to Virtumart. So Virtumart is where everything is connected together. And then this is just an idea to create web apps or maybe mobile phone apps. So once we have the API ready and implemented, it's fairly easy to create web apps. So the J and Beyond app that you guys use on the iPhone, it might as well have been using the JSON article feed. And if there was a scheduling component on the website, we could have just wrote an API for that, and the web app uses the API. So, I mean, the it's really up to the imagination of developers what can be used for. So, yeah, so this is, I mean, by telling all this, one major point that I wanted to put forward is we already see a lot of API projects. There is PlexiCloud, there is Relax API, which came in a few days back. Then there is Calm API. So, I mean, Joomla developers tend to develop a lot of things, same thing over and over again. We have 10 shops, we have 10 CCKs. So, I think we need to change that. We need to just focus on one single REST API, and then make extension developers aware of the availability, and then just ask them to develop for one REST API. That's how Drupal does it. So if you use Drupal, there's just one CCK module, there's just one users module, and there's just one shop, maybe two. But it's not like Joomla, where we have 10 things for each feature. So I mean, my thought is to go that way, so that we just have one REST API that people use and develop on, so that it's also easy for extension developers. They just have to stick to one API. that's where I mean, if any of you guys are using PlexiCloud, RelaxCom API, or are developers of the same, I mean, I'm open to just kind of collaborate and make sure that we just have one API extension for Joomla. Now, I mean, you might be wondering, Nuku is there, why did I work on this? But the thing is, for existing extensions which don't have Nuku, which are not built on Nuku, there's a problem, because I was talking to Johan yesterday. Firstly, it's not possible. And I also brought up the topic of being able to create a REST API server for Joomla using Nuku, but that's not very easy as well. So that's the reason this thing is there. And until 100% extensions are built on Nuku, we definitely need some kind of server for Joomla, and that's why we're doing this. So I have an appeal for all developers to kind of collaborate and make sure we have just one. So that's the Molajo school of thought as well. So, and yeah, and ultimately, if all goes well, it'll be great if the core guys take it into the Joomla core. We already have XML RPC, and it's kind of getting obsolete. And REST is the way of today. It's lightweight, it's fast, so the REST is the way to go. So I really hope if the core guys get it into the Joomla core, that will be excellent. So yeah, that's the end of the presentation. Now we'll just quickly go through some demos that I have of the ready APIs. So the first one is a very simple one of being able to create a user in Joomla. I guess are most of you developers over here? So yeah, so I can directly open the code and show it to you. So what we are doing over here is So this is the authentication I spoke about. Admin is my super admin user. The password is 123456. So this is the authentication part. Now I mentioned that we have Joomla and profile type support. So this is the profile type ID that we have. Email, name, password. So these are just the Joomla required fields that we are putting in. First thing that we do is a user create. So I send a user create request. So let's see the demo now. Okay, so if you see, it says message, username or email already in use. So we already support error messages in the response. So this means that you have an error, the email is already in use, so you need to use a different email. Let's change that to Peter. Let's see what happens. Okay, so it worked. So the ID is the ID of the user that's created new. So that's your JSON response. Now I'm doing a read after the write. So the read is being read based on the ID. This is the past result of the read. And then we are doing an update. When we do an update, we are just changing the name for the moment. We are changing the name to my name. So the update is successful. It returns the ID of the user it updated, and then we do a read again, and this time it shows you the new name. Okay. Maybe the update is not happening. Something wrong, but yeah, once you update, it would update all of your fields to the new one that you sent. And when you do a read again, it would show the new ones. And I've commented out delete for now. I'll just put in delete. So what we did is we just created a new user. So if you look at the URL, I'm using the REST client. and this is the Joomla installation the server sits on. So let's try to log in using the user we created. Get logged in. So we did not create a user in the admin. So there's nothing, there's no magic that's going on. It's just the REST API that's doing its trick. It created a user and then you were able to log in using that user. So it's that simple. So you can assume that the file that I'm using, it's kind of a third party tool like Moodle or Docios or any e-learning system or any kind of system that wants to sell access to Joomla sites. So once you have a confirmed order, you just fire API request to your Joomla. User. So it's as simple as that. And it's so this time we have kept the delete request open, so it would do a delete at the end. So we had a create, so the ID is 90, which is one more than the last one. The read shows that the guy is created. There's an update. Update is not happening. And then delete. So Roland at Jab does not exist anymore. If you try to log in. So it got deleted. So that's the way the CRUD works. The next demo that we have is a simple user filter. So we can filter based on ID, we can filter based like this, and then we can also filter based on the name. So that's a simple user filter. So it's this, the user filter can be extended to filtering for other stuff like groups and like that. And then finally we have the search API. So the search API exactly uses the same features as the Joomla search. So what I'm gonna do is search something over here. Okay, so we search for guide and we found 3 results. Now I'm gonna do the same over here. We have the same 3 results. So it's exactly using the same Joomla plugins, Joomla search architecture to do the search, and it's extending it onto a REST front so that you can integrate Joomla search in any number of sites. So let's say you want to create a flash based front end for Joomla, you can use all these APIs to create a nice looking site, whereas it's Joomla is working behind the scenes, so it can be as good as that. Yeah. Even if you install more search plugins, they'll work over here. So if you install the Virtuomart search plugin, it works over here. So that's what we did. No, we won't. So when you install a new search plugin in Joomla, the search starts appearing over here. So the same happens for the REST API as well. You don't need to really extend it. It uses all of the search type plugins that Joomla has and then the results. Yeah. No. So what the search API is doing is the same as what the search component does. So it talks to the plugins, it takes all the results, and that's what the search API does. So if you install more search plugins, it starts working straight away. Affiliate system. Yeah. It will not. So unless you have a
Joomla search plugin for Virtuemart, it will not work. So the way we did it is we created a Joomla search plugin for Virtuemart, and that's what we implemented. So that's the demo of the plugins. If you want, I can just quickly take you through the server code. So we have this very similar to the XML RPC. What we are doing is, we are getting the request URI, and as I said, we are mapping the end of the URL, which is user underscore create.json, to the user underscore create plugin. So we are just trying to fetch the URI and then find out the request response format. So as I said, we are only doing post and get for now. So post or get, we are authenticating the API caller, we are doing the regular Joomla login over here. So if it's a super admin, he is allowed to go ahead. If it's not, no authentication. It'll work. So it's using the exact same authentication as Joomla, so any plugin, anything you have, works. As long as the user is super admin. And then we are getting all the REST API plugins, and so the server also supports one nice feature, which is able to being able to describe your plugin. So if you create a new plugin, maybe for Virtuemart, then it's possible for you to put definitions in your plugin. The definitions will show what is the expected inputs, what are the outputs that we are getting, which ones are mandatory, which ones are not. So using the on REST info method in your plugins, you can describe your methods as well. So, and then finally we have the output format. If it's JSON, we just set it to JSON and then do a JSON encode. If it's XML, we just output XML. We'll just quickly try to do a post with a fake not authenticated user. So it says cannot log in. So if you can't log in, it says cannot log in. So we are already supporting so this is the kind of error message we are supporting. You can't log in, which is not log in. And previously we saw the errors which said the email is used up, the username is used up, because Joomla requires both the email and username to be unique. So if anything of that is not valid, it throws an error. So that's mostly from my side. Now if you have any questions, I'll be glad to tackle those. By the way, we've already released this. So any of you can just download it, deploy it, start using it. It's on Git. You can fork it. Yep. Make more plugins. Make the server better. And it's real social coding. So they're just doing it very well. So any more questions?